on me.
Breathe
on me. Lift up your hands and sing it. This is what I believe God tells me. And I know if I ask this, everything here, I believe, and most of you but television would say, I want him to breathe on me. And I appreciate that hunger and that thirst and that desire, but that's not what I'm talking about. There are some of you here tonight, you really need it badly. I mean badly. I don't know what it is. It may be sin. It may be hurt. It may be discouragement. It may be pain. It may be disillusionment. It may be you've lost faith. It's a terrible thing to lose your faith. You've watched the flame flicker and die until there's nothing left but a dying ember. And he tells you tonight, I'm going to blow on it and spring it to life again. I don't know your need, but maybe you're in a cave. You're where Elijah is or was. He's got better things for you than to rot in a hole in the ground. He's got a chariot of fire waiting for you. Do you hear what I'm telling you? If that need is really there up in the balcony, the main floor of the choir, out on the preachers, I don't care who it is, you earnestly, hungrily need desperately for him to breathe on you. I don't mean you just want a touch from God, but you need it desperately. I want you to step out. I want you to come. Heaven will see you. The Holy Ghost will see you. They'll watch you walk down these aisles. I want you to come. Oh, let him breathe on me.
Let him breathe on me. Let the breath of God
now breathe
on me. Let him breathe on me.
I sense God's presence. Surround these folk, will you? Give me about 200 children of God to just form a cordon around these people. Come on, saints. Come on, saints. Oh, let the breath of God now breathe on me. Open up your life to it. Let it breathe on you. I'm not a Calabasas. it again, Sheila. Sing it again, Richie.